You know the vibes. Last week, I was in Paris covering the NBA Paris game. So we did something different with the podcast. I gave you some interviews from the archive. But while I was out there, my good friends at NBA 2K24 got me a couple minutes to sit down with Mr. Channing Frye. And we had a little chat. So I wanted to share that with you guys. Don't worry. This one's a quick one. But the full interview, that's coming. We're going to figure it out. We're going to get Channing on the show. We're going to have a little debate, and you're going to see what we're going to debate about. Here's a little preview for you guys. Hope you enjoy it. Make sure you subscribe so you can see the full interview when it drops. Oh, and by the way, Channing's luggage got lost by the airline. That's why the start of the interview, you can hear a little back and forth about that as well.
Good. Nice to meet you. You got your luggage?
We got it.
But they found it.
They found it. It's just taking forever to get here.
Okay.
So yeah.
Still
so,
vital.
I'm trying, you know.
You in the J's though?
No, I do have J's. They're in the luggage.
Okay.
These are walkers. So like anytime I go to a city, New York, Paris, London, I'll throw these on because like if it's snowing or wet, I don't want to get my J's all out there. Right. So being the thing of journey, I just, you know.
That's why I go ride two pairs, one to rock, one to stock.
Yeah.
I go to J's, he's got a New Balance. I play on PlayStation, Channing plays on Xbox. So
yeah.
I'm just going to ask you a couple quick questions.
Yeah, please.
You know you're on a tight schedule. I want to throw you in the deep end. Some play, we have 2K, right. My team, you got to pick your all-time starting five.
Shaq, Tim Duncan, LeBron, Kobe Jordan.
Okay.
That was easy.
Okay. That's nice.
That was easy.
Okay. Predictions for this season. Champions of the Eastern Conference.
The 76ers.
Okay. And being going to show up in the playoffs this time.
Dude, yeah. I think we big men mature later. And I also think him being married and all these off-court things, right? And obviously, I look at all these things as I'm watching these teams over and over and over again. But Joel has figured out he can't win the way he was playing. And now you're starting to see Tobias, my cousin, balling. Yep. Tyrese Maxey's balling. He can have all the stats in the world, but if his team isn't successful, it doesn't equate to his narrative, right? Mm-hmm. So I think he's finally understood that, like, yes, I'm the focal point of this offense, but other people got to eat too. Mm-hmm. I think Nick Nurse is a great coach for him, challenging him, and then I think Tyrese Maxey is the exact perfect complement that he needs to Batman to his Robin.
So if they're making the finals, who's coming out of the West?
Oh, it's Denver. I don't think it's close. That's easy.
Embiid and Jokic head-to-head in the finals. That would be epic, but who's winning it and in how many games?
Oh, I don't know. It's like King Kong versus Godzilla right there. Boy, I'll say a big money for that. Okay, here's how I do it. Okay, you would say the top two players would be Jokic and Embiid, and then who's the next top guy?
Jamal
Murray. Do you think Jamal Murray is better than Tyrese Maxey?
In the NBA
right
finals.
Now.
No, in we're the talking NBA right finals. When we talk about regular season.
Listen, we're not now. Talking because I could talk about, you know, Bill Walton was great in 72. We're talking about this year, Tyrese Maxey's having a better year than Jamal Murray.
Okay. So, okay. That's wise, yes.
So then it goes Jamal Murray, obviously, and then you would say Tobias or Aaron Gordon.
Yeah.
Okay. And then you would say
Michael Porter Jr.
Or
that's where you run out. You go Nick Batum. You know what I'm saying? I think Denver, they've got experience. This we could do a whole debate.
We could.
I'm gonna get you on the Hoop Genius podcast for myself and BJ.
Okay, that'd be great.
But you obviously have your own podcast.
Right.
Road trip, and now you're in Paris.
Right.
Dream podcast guest that you haven't had on yet.
Oh man.
Aside from myself.
Dream podcast guest. So we had an opportunity to interview Tim Duncan early in our, you know, the beginning of road tripping. I'd love, because he was the guy that I looked up to. I'd love to get him on with Dirk at the same time. I think that power forward position is like almost non-existent kind of today, other than maybe Zion and AD. So for me, just to really talk about those guys, what it was like, their transition from that big man dominant league to kind of the guard centric 3-point shooting league, the spacing, and just kind of like what their take is on it. So, those two guys.
Now, you had a great career yourself.
Oh, thank you.
Won a championship. But I want to know if you put prime Channing Frye in today's NBA,
yeah,
which team would you want to play on?
Damn. how old prime Channing Frye was, like 18. And I asked people, people are like, oh, Channing, you make so much money. But the thing, when I shot, I didn't know dribbling wasn't like, Chet is 7'2". Mm-hmm. It handles like a guard. Wemby handles like a guard. AD handles like a guard. That is something I'd have to, so you'd have to get 18-year-old Channing, teach him how to shoot threes and how to dribble and play the game the opposite way that I learned as like a power forward. But what team? Denver would be great. I think Oklahoma City would be a sleeper. Honestly, Miami. I like their system. I like teams where they move bodies, right? Where, you know, you're learning and reading, reacting. And maybe even have an opportunity to go to San Antonio and learn how to pop. Those would be the right four teams that I would try.
Man, that's awesome. Listen, I appreciate you taking the time.
Yeah.
I got a business.
Thank you, man.
To get you on the Hoop Cheese podcast.
Please. Yeah.
I'd love only why the Sixers aren't making the final.
Ah, please.
Stay tuned for that one.
So let me know. Join the Discord server that's linked below. Do you think the Philadelphia 76ers are going to make the NBA finals? Channing Frye seems to think so, but we're going to get him back on the show. We're going to have a full-on debate, because after the camera stopped rolling there, you know, I had to turn up the heat a little bit, but that's nothing compared to what's going to happen when he comes on the full show. So make sure you subscribe to the channel, subscribe on YouTube, Spotify, Apple, wherever you get your podcasts from. Appreciate you guys. Make sure you're locking with the Hoop Genius podcast every day. And most importantly, get buckets.